I had a feeling less about mathematics as I saw it all. Depth beyond depth was revealed to me, abyss and abyss. My tergiversation was inevitable, but it was after dinner and I let it go.
Music, architecture, statuary, tapestry, and porcelain.
Alice laughed. There's no use trying, she said. One can't believe impossible things. I dare say you haven't had much practice, said the Queen. When I was younger, I always did it for half an hour a day. Why, sometimes I believed as many as six impossible things before breakfast. MKUltra. Now if you wanna educate yourself about the CIA and LSD, I recommend you hop on over to your nearest web browser and do a search with the keyword MKUltra. In particular, I highly recommend John Mark's little book, The Search for the Manchurian Candidate, the entire text of which you can find online at www.druglibrary.org. There you can read all about one Dr. Sidney Gottlieb, curious sort of man. Gottlieb was in charge of most of the CIA's LSD experiments since the 50s, if you can call them experiments. There certainly wasn't much scientific about them anyway. Basically consisted of dosing people pretty much at random, damn near anybody and everybody, including each other. You show up at work one day, have your morning coffee, you start going over some important cable from the Nepal or some other hole, and wham, next thing you know, you're tripping your ass off on several hundred micrograms of pure Sandoz. They hit anyone, anywhere, you name it. They even set up safe houses in San Francisco, where they'd lure some pure sucker off the street with a hooker. She'd take him into a totally rigged up bachelor pad, where we could watch him all on two-way mirrors. Then they'd dose him with everything they had, all kinds of experimental chemicals and hallucinogens barely known to anyone. Then there was the case of one Dr. D.E. Cameron, of the Allen Memorial Institute at McGill University. His experiments centered around attempts at what he called depatterning. His typical subject would be a 50s-style housewife, who'd had a nervous breakdown, perhaps exhibiting moderately schizophrenic tendencies. The good doctor would subject this unwitting participant to a great many abuses, including massive electroshock treatments many times stronger than conventionally applied, days after days of long periods of drug-induced sleep, repeated applications of powerful hallucinogens, and hours of tape loops containing extremely disturbing material, something he called psychic driving. All this insane crap would be forced on some poor housewife type in an attempt to wipe away her defective personality, ostensibly to be replaced with a more obedient and normal personality. All this work, of course, was secretly funded by the CIA. Dr. Carmarin, as it turns out, was president of the American Psychiatric Association, president of the Canadian Psychiatric Association, president of the World Psychiatric Association. Just goes to show you.